Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to the Dreams of Poland mod, which we're playing as a kind of thick Habsburg Empire. Last time, we were struggling quite a bit against the Soviets, and eventually, mostly because the Romanians intervened in the war, but they're gone now, forever dead, and all taken out by the Greeks as well, but that's okay. Right now, we are, of course, grueling, or on our way to the Highway of Hell, to, of course, the major big three cities of the Soviet Union. And hopefully we can continue smashing them, even though we may be out of artillery, support equipment, light tanks, anti-air, you know, all the good stuff. Regardless, no matter how many casualties we may take, how many deaths that may be inflicted on us, we all can rest assured that the amount of casualties that we inflict upon the Soviet Union are drastically much more than us. Because they're completely out of equipment. Completely out. They're doing smirsh. They're trying to naval invade us in Western Poland. They could try, but they're going to die doing it. Stockpile-wise, just, they got a few armored cars, fighters, a few planes, that's pretty much it. So, we established that last time, and they're trying to naval invade us, and look at all that green in the south. The central north portion, not doing so great, but the south, oh, we're pushing in so well. You guys are doing well. And actually, we've just lost a few token divisions on the Italian border. You know, they don't look very strong, but with some ground support focus. Right now, at this point, I'm thinking we could probably use more steel. Actually, we could really, really, really use more steel. But we need to start focusing on a navy. The Polish Navy. The Polish Navy might be a bit of a misnomer, and it currently consists of several submarines and destroyers and a handful of river patrol ships. Our small coastline limits our naval production and the size of our navy, but at least we are less vulnerable to invasion from the seas. Our admirals have some interesting ideas for potential navy. Cool. Now, we could try to attack, which I don't understand why these guys are so weak all the time, but we could try it, you know. We always have a good defensive line to fall back upon. I don't know how you guys are so incredibly weak, though. Like, it makes no sense here. How are you so weak? I mean, I get it that you're fighting the French. Oh my gosh. We just decimated their little butts. The little Italian booties, they would just go bye-bye. I think they probably try to naval invade, but as long as they can't take a port, it doesn't really matter too much. Yeah, we're doing really well down there. Nice. Actually, we should... after that, we should probably actually focus on this stuff here. Ooh, where is it? Right here. Expand the Dwojka. Polish Imperium? Only unlocked by certain paths. Gain special puppets called Protectorates. We've got a couple of comments to go through, though, that even though the game just said puppets. It was recommended that we actually restore the Tsardom of, not Bulgaria, Russia, because that seems like a very cool idea, so we'll try that. What else? We basically had the second miracle in the Vistula yesterday, where Warsaw was basically our literal frontline city, and we weren't trying to die, so pretty much, second miracle on the Vistula. The Metamors is the Intermarium. For some reason, I always forget that. Then again, that's a Polish version of saying it, so I guess you can understand why I forgot about that. So, it is what it is, and yes, it is. Intermarium, Metamors, the good stuff, of course. Just kill them off, please, 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 please. If we could actually take out Italy this few divisions, that'd be great. Actually, you know what, from here on out, if we make more divisions, make sure they come here. Because we might be able to push actually into them. Because they're so weak. They've lost so many. 1.1 million to France. We've cut off 500,000 of them ourselves, but my goodness. Even their tanks can't compete. Ooh, send you right here then. Now, this one might be a bit of a stretch, but with enough support from everyone, you can do pretty darn well. There you go. Actually, do we have any planes? As we're grinding on the Eastern Front. But grinding in a good way. Grinding in a good way. Oh man, they really want Gdansk, don't they? Ooh, you guys are doing okay. You guys are over there. You guys are down here. So... Oh, you guys were actually pushed out, were you? Sorry, I'll have you guys push through here. There you go. Come to Sevastopol. Take it. Link up with the guys over there, because we will... Oh, we have research. My bad. Yeah. I was talking about doing this stuff. We have cruisers, which is nice. We gotta start thinking about carriers. I want to do carriers in this campaign if we have to go to war with the Allies for realsies. So, just because, why not? Polish carriers? Because we can. Because we care. What are the strengths of the Italians right now? No manpower. Well, I guess that's why their divisions aren't looking so good. Not sure about their stockpile, though. I mean, we could potentially try to attack. They are out of manpower. Let's wait for them to finish their defenses first. Going on over here. More convoys. I love it. Oh, look, we got even more green now. Oh, wow. We're pushing fast and hard down there. select, boom. Boom. Boom, boom, boom. 1, 2, 3, boom. Now I can't have 11, so actually you go right there. And then you go right there. Repair. Everyone get ready to go. Nice. Wow, we have really done quite a bit here. Keep them in place. You actually go right there, help them out. And then you two just go beeline here to encircle them. Whee! If you guys could actually win, that'd be amazing. Can you guys actually win down here? I want planes, though. And this is a pretty small line, but we might do okay. We probably just have to manually control for the realsies, though. For the realsies. Oh, yeah, we throw more divisions. Their organization or strength just starts to collapse. Yes. Oh, yeah. That is nice. Investment portfolio. Sure, why not? I'm not going to help them out until we win the war, but whatever. All right, let's go do... Expand the Dwojska. The second department of the Polish General Staff, Dwojska, is a branch of the General Staff tasked with all matters regarding military intelligence, counter-intel, and cryptography. Poland is home to some of the world's greatest mathematicians, and all cryptology really boils down to is its mathematics. As such, we have one of the finest intelligence agencies in the world. Expanding can only make it a better place, or just better overall. Very cool. Machine-assisted decryption. Some more passive defense. We could become a spy master. We got probably a few other things to do. Oh, look at all that green. We're expanding down here so quickly. So actually, I'm going to use you guys to come back up north. I will actually probably go just do that. And then we'll send you down to the Italian border as they're trying to attack us and try to smash through their lines. I think it's time. I'm pretty sure it's time. Oh, we actually lost a sub. That's not good. Air stuff. How's our... Ooh, let's finish up our line doctrine. Just a little bit more recon for recon. Do we have recon on our soldiers anyways? Yes, we do. Communist China. Nah, we good for now. Yeah, with you guys, signal companies, anti-air might be really good to do. Basic submarine snorkels, cool. Ooh, we want carriers. I really, really, actually really want carriers in this campaign. Let's go with some dual-purpose secondary batteries. We can throw those on pretty much any ship that we have. And the Allies still can't break through here. Why can't we see this, huh? They're still pretty strong over here, actually. Compared to over here, which they're pretty darn weak, that's okay. Any upgrades for Mr. Mieczysław Boruta Spilsiewicz? I don't know, I'm not Polish at all. Sorry. Oh, also was recommended in the comments yesterday that I should get a cat cam. I don't know, maybe. We'll see what happens. Don't think it'll probably happen, but that's okay. Oh man, we are doing so well. How many Soviets have we killed so far? The answer is, not enough. Only 4.7 million? No, no. Actually, how many divisions do they have? I wasn't paying attention. There's still quite a few divisions, but that's okay. Once we can smash through these Italians, it's over. It's over for the Axis. Ooh, actually, we're losing quite a few subs. That's not good. We lost quite a few subs. Holy cow. There you go. Well, now we have 1940 subs, which should make things a little bit better. Let's grab some magnetic detonators so we can always get more attack right now. There you go. Thank you. Well, we're going to use them. I might as well say goodbye to you. Goodbye. You got one more. And then... I almost always use radar, snorkel. It really doesn't help you that much, but you know what? I almost never use it, so we might as well use it now. We can always get more detection if we actually use regular radar, I believe, so... There you go. And there you go. The Witcher class? No, we good. That's a long game. Witcher 3. Oh my goodness, that is a very, very long game. Go, guys, go! Actually, stockpile supplies. We're doing a little worse on artillery now. Guns are still looking pretty good. Motorized looking actually pretty darn decent. Wow, that's a lot of motorized we have. 20. We could probably lower by 5 and throw on 5 more for support equipment for now. That'd be fine. Out of rubber, but what else is new? Nope. Probably build up a few more... factories, actually. Yeah, we still gotta build some roads here. Ladder road's gonna be built. Passive defense are nice. Very good. Very good, very good. And then build it right there. There you go. Nice. So we can still go to war with the Serbs, hopefully. Yep, yes we can. Which, actually, we should probably go to war with them. We'll go to war with them once we beat the Soviets. Because hopefully they join the Axis and not the Allies, because that would be pretty bad for us. Expand the group. cool. Ooh, decisions gain free upgrade from the intelligence agency. Oh, okay. Department Ila of the Dvojak is tasked with intelligence gathering and is itself separated into two sub-departments, Bureau East and Bureau West. With Germany to our west and the Soviets to our east, both bureaus are of equally critical importance. Ooh. I thought we already set up that's right. Cool. Nice. Lots of subs for now. Lots of subby boys. Oh, come on. Get to Baku if we can. I can't imagine the Soviets holding for that much longer. I mean, it's a lot less divisions than we started with this war with. Oh, just go right here. Just cut them off immediately. That'd be so good. Anyone else have upgrades? I know the fighting's pretty brutal over here. We lost quite a few divisions. Maybe not quite a few, but a couple divisions, really. A few divisions. Ambusher, no. Guerrilla fighters, okay. No, we good. Because after this war, I'm definitely going to be upgrading some of these guys. They definitely deserve it. Alrighty, tidy. We don't want to win this war too fast. We really want to win this part. I think overall it's probably just better if I actually send you guys back to the Eastern Front. Because we're going to win pretty soon, hopefully. But, yeah. Let's beat the Soviets first, even though we will end up in a war with Japan, I believe, because they're fighting the East Indies. So. See that? 42. More breakthrough in defense. Yes, please. Sign me up. And we're going to need some more manpower. Finally. We're only on limited conscription, so going to extensive conscription would not be a problem. And do we have anything else here? Yes, we do. Thank you. Yes, good, good, good. Hey, artillery's looking a lot better now. Gun's looking like it's going down slightly, but we do have a cup of coffee here to keep us nice and warm, like normal. Do you need more upgrades, actually? Oh, yeah, you do. Smoke screen would not be bad. Silent Hunter. Torpedo reveal chance. I like the hit chance. I like the torpedo cooldown, though. You can just throw out more torpedoes. I'm thinking that's better than a hit chance, because even though you get 10% more hit chance, that's only 10%. 25% means out of 4, you get 1 more quickly. So, screen penetration. I like penetration. Cool. Yeah, C-42, we could do that stuff. Come over here. I'm thinking more Navy stuff. Torpedoes are okay. Let's go cruiser hulls. We need them. Develop a navy, especially against the Allies eventually. The Allies are pathetic. I mean, my goodness, look how pathetic they are. They can't even navally invade Italy. They're not that strong. And, ooh, you got... Okay, I guess the Reich's decryption stuff is ready to go. Could become a spy mask, but we're good for now. Let's go ahead and grab some of this stuff. 2 hydrophones. This will definitely help. Fleet speed when retreating. That'll help our subs when they get encountered by somebody, so... Pretty strong subs. Oh, actually, if we get attacked right here, cut these guys off, but they do have a port right down there. We need to focus on our airships. Not by airships, I mean planes. A little bit more. If you could take Baku, that would be great. Who can give me the steel? Yeah, that's not good enough. There you go. Actually, what if we dump the steel and got the stuff we would need from those guys, and then got a little bit more from Siam? I love trade deals. Yeah, not doing bad at all. Making even more factories right now? You can do that, why not? You can do that by 1. I think that'll be good enough. We have almost roughly 60 pieces of support equipment made every single day. That is so good. That's pretty good, too. That's pretty good, too. Fighters looking pretty good. Anti-air actually is looking a little bit lacking, of all things. Ace pilot promoted. Very good. Keep building up more roads. Do we have another operative slot? Yes, we do. Lesik Grabowski. Hello, Grabowski. Grabowski. Oh, boy. The fall of Tokyo, a significant... American has invaded... Okay, maybe we don't have to fight the Japanese. Sure. Why not? Why not? And actually, you know, I'm going to set you guys up to medium priority, because I do want to make those planes better. You know what, screw it. I lied. Just get rid of... any planes that you have less of 30, I'm just going to get rid of. Nah, we good. I don't even care if these are replacements. I don't want to see them in the list. I still can't believe we can't do anything about that. Studies Department 4. Oh, yeah, agency upgrade time, minus 50%. Like the Intelligence Department, the Studies Department is distributed in such a way that Germany and Russia both have their own bureau dedicated to them, in addition to a more generally focused bureau. Department 4 is tasked with understanding the long-term implications of policy or military developments in foreign nations. That's so good. Oh, Siam. We probably can't trade with you then anymore. That sucks. Also, it's nice. I don't really need it, though. Hey, look, an encirclement. Oh my goodness. 60 visions, not bad. We probably can't pierce them as well normally, but, you know, once they die. It's okay. Ooh, what are we lacking here? Siam. Oh, Siam. Why? Armored cars. That makes sense. Medium tanks. Yeah, we could do that by now. Actually, yeah. No, I want just either light tanks or modern tanks. There will be no in-between. France. Oh, you actually have two things. You're the allies. I don't want to trade with the allies. Well, I'm not going to trade with the proper allies. The Raj, they've been beaten down too much that I will trade with them. Screw the allies. They're not getting anything from Germany. They can get a little piece of Italy, when we're done here. But hopefully in time, we don't need to worry about that. So, you know what? Just to help these guys out, force the attack. Break them. You can break them too. I'm doing these two just because they already have planes on them, so. Oh my goodness, we must have gotten Baku. Oh yes. Yes, 98 more fuel. Yes, 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 yes. 1,000 times yes. Actually, throw on 20 more factories there just because we're going to need that. If that's the case, come here and do Krakow. Man, all the infrastructure here has been so heavily damaged. Oof. Oh, we can upgrade the department. Apply the upgraded civilian to your intelligence. Oh, you can just auto do it. Oh, that's so OP. I love it. Countess. Oh, we do need to go to war with these guys, too. Is this... Oh, yeah, it is. If I go to war with them, what's going to happen? Do we get a war against them later on? Maybe we do. Maybe we don't need to do that. But, 36 carrier hull. Let's see. We still need to do that stuff over there. Transylvania? No. Spain? Italy? That's it. Okay, so we do have to do manually... Actually, hold on. Maybe not manually do it. We have a colonial empire here, too. The Poles have always had a unique European people, or been a unique European people, in the fact that they were much more often than not the victims of foreign subjugation. As such, we've never had the chance to expand ourselves across the globe like other great powers. During the scramble for Africa and the colonization of the New World, there were a few attempts by Lithuanians to establish colonies, yet all ended in failure. Let us remedy these mistakes and show the world that we can oppress others just as well as like any other European nation. Ugh, I love oppression. As long as we're doing the oppressing, that's totally fine. Totally fine. Other people do it to us, we're the victims. Absolutely. Research, thank you. Depth charge thrower. We could do this stuff. We just got that one done. We're going to get light cruisers. We might as well do basic medium batteries because we're going to need that. How many planes can you throw on here? Anger by Lithuanian posturing. You bet we are. 20 at max. But I always like throwing on a little bit of armor just in case. This way, light ships should not be able to pierce us, but they still might be able to, but whatever. We're going to get some more torpedo reveal chance. Minus 25%. It's some extremely lethal subs as we drink our coffee together. If you have any, of course. I did not put it in the belts there, huh? Loads of subs. Submarino it up. Oh, we must have taken Moscow and Stalingrad. Studies for department? Great. Three guys actually... You know what? Continue throwing them right there. I think we have enough divisions on the Eastern Front anyways, so... Cypher department. So, it would not be an exaggeration to say that Poland has the world's finest cypher department, all thanks to the talented mathematical geniuses in its employment. There's no code that cannot be cracked by our team, not even the famed German Enigma machine. Already our agents are close to cracking it and developing the Enigma cipher. More decryption. If we decrypt the German Reich cipher, we get the following national spirits, which means nothing for us because we already killed off the Germans. We could, well, permanently lost if we activate the cipher decryption bonus against... Oh! We will permanently lose the Polish cipher department if we actually decrypt this stuff. Oh. Well, I'm glad we killed him off then. Okay, so now the allies are slowly breaking in. If they break in too far, I will do a general attack. Actually, we're making 40 combat with divisions or... No, we're not. Get out of here. You guys. Either 40s or nothings. You're gonna be some thick kids. Well, no, maybe not kids, but thick divisions. Oh, yeah, let's say thick divisions. Oof. Oh, we lost a sub. That sucks. Looking pretty good on the Soviet Union. They're not out of dead Soviets, though. We need more... Oh, we actually finished down here. I forgot to look at these guys. I'm not sure what to do. Ooh, you know what? I'm gonna do this off-screen just so that we can give it to the Allies, because we don't need to mess with this. Alright, my friends, sorry about that, but I have done the peace deal so that China got most of, well, China. And they also gave him, I also gave him North Korea, but gave South Korea to the United States just because I think they did probably most of the work invading Japan, so. Japanese is looking a little blue right now, and maybe we'll have a divided Korea. Maybe we will, maybe we won't, but we just finished infiltration and depth, so we have more recon and more reinforcement, but we are done now with our land doctrine. Thank goodness. Artillery, anyone? Yes, please. Yes, please. Hopefully Japan pops out eventually. We'll see what happens. And I gave him Taiwan. Look at Taiwan and Hawaii mixed up together. These guys, of course, obviously not on that area. Enemy agent turned. Prokhor. Soviet agent. That's weird. How we get the Soviet agent captured after we turn the agent. But we expect her to die? Double agent. I like double agents. Especially if they say Prokhor. Or however you pronounce it. I have no idea. Are you learning some more? Yes, he's becoming a superior tactician, which is a great, great thing. Yes. Protect the Dutch West Indies. I mean, you know, sure. Free protection from the Allies? Or from the U.S., I guess you should really say, because they're not actually in the Allies. Okay. Why not? Anyone guaranteeing these guys yet? Not yet, which is a good thing. People might eventually do that, but we're doing so well against the Soviets. Hello. Why do you... Okay, the Finns took Leningrad. Come on, man. Come on, man. 6.4 million? That's not enough. No, no, no. Those less than 100 divisions? No, no, no. We gotta kill off more than that. That's fake news, man. That's totally fake news. Let's get some more manpower, too, before we end this war. And then, actually, we will go to war with our armies. Combined armies. Smash straight through Yugoslavia. Ooh, the Allies are actually doing a little better down here, too. Well, that's good for them. Too bad I'm gonna be... Once we smash the Yugoslavians, the Italians are just gonna be going bye-bye as fast as possible. Oh, we even have the trade port or the trade note of Astrakhan. Oh, yes. Can you imagine if that was actually trade in Hoi4? That'd be kind of... That'd be so messy. Oh, has not done... Oh! Passive defense upgrade. Whoopsie. I guess we didn't have to do that one manually. Oh, well. In addition to being responsible for its namesake, the Intelligence Planning Department is also tasked with developing newer and better propaganda techniques and methods of sabotage. Finally, it'll also oversee all of our field agents. Oh, cool. So at this point, let's go ahead and keep doing more stuff then. Government staff for schools. Awesome. Can only still get... We're mobilizing now. 1.42 political power a day. Colonized places. 40. Nice. Heck, we might start developing a lot of this stuff, actually. Probably this would be pretty good to do. Let's keep doing a little bit more of our... Not our air doctrine. Planes. A little bit ahead of time. Eh, why not? Look at the best cast possible. What's the difference between... Carrier... Close air support, and carrier naval bombers. Because in TNO, when you play TNO, you don't have naval bombers anymore. You have carrier... Oh, look at that. Wow, that's a lot of steel. Carrier close air support, and carrier fighters. But no carrier bombers. I'm interested in learning, like, what's the difference? Is there a massive difference in that? Because I've not found one yet, so... But I'm sure there is. There's gotta be, right? You guys go down here and do that. Focus more on the northern regions. Now that Japan's gone, this is one of the rare campaigns where I've seen America. Oh, actually, how far do you go down? You go all the way down there, huh? America, like, take out Japan and not be part of the Allies. I'd say that's a little bit rare. But that's just me. They're not even any faction, period. Let's move a little bit faster, guys. And this one, you're looking good already. Even more factories? Decrypting the Enigma machine. We've managed to break the German secret Enigma machine, an encryption device used to pass secret information. None of this would have been possible without the brilliant Polish mathematicians and cryptanalysts Marian Radziuski, Jerzy Rojewski, and Henryk Zygalski. With the code successfully broken, we will now be able to know where the German units move, what their plans are, and even decrypt secret messages between the upper level of the German government and the Wehrmacht. We must be careful how we use this information, though, as it becomes clear that they've broken... That we've broken their code, and we'll quickly come up with a new one. If we play it smart, we can keep the Germans in the dark about this for years. The Germans thought their Enigma machine's encryption was undecipherable. We broke it in about a month. Our agents and mathematicians are second to none. Well, it's a good thing the Germans are gone. Actually, if you're going to be at the... Let's put you at the bottom. Because I want a lot of steel for this, and we'll put you there. Cool. Actually, we need more armored cars, too, actually. But since we'll probably restore the it's not bad, we might as well start using this one. Once we restore the Tsardom of... Well, that's not... great, actually. Restore the Tsardom of Russia. Yeah, we'll see what happens. I mean, oh man, we definitely have to do better battery stuff. Fire control 0, radar 3. We need batteries, so we're not even going to do that for now, then. I don't want to put garbage guns on them. Even though, technically, they won't... I don't use... Oh, man, this is... You get this done so quickly. Go and do that, too. You don't use light cruisers... at least, I don't use light cruisers when trying to sink enemy ships. It's all about the capital ships, in my opinion. Capital ships are kings of the sea. There you go. Good luck. Good luck. Don't die too much. Come on, the Soviets have got to capitulate soon enough. I mean, they're so close. Look at that. 91% of the way there. Hey, America, sure. Oh, are we out of infantry equipment? Oh, yeah, we are. Wow. Wowzers and Bowsers. Well, that ain't good. Just build a lot of that stuff up, then. That'll be okay. Because we do own a lot of territory around here. Actually, armored cars. We're doing much better. We're doing a lot better on artillery. Government staff for schools. We upgrade these things so fast. I love it. This is totally not OP at all. And the next one we'll do after this is come back to the Navy. Because we... ooh, actually, we need to build stuff up here. City development is actually pretty good to do. Infrastructure... well, actually, we've already been building a lot of infrastructure up. Oh, well. Land air coordination, ground support. Ooh, ground bomber focus, radar, Warsaw stuff, Polish Marine Corps. Ooh, fleet and being, treaty interdiction, Madman's base strike. I think this is for the carriers. Okay, so the purpose of a thought of experiment, Admiral Zalory Chernicki was asked by the government to develop a naval buildup strategy to attempt to emulate the U.S. and Japanese navies. Centered around the use of aircraft carriers and naval aircraft, we could strike our enemies from a distance for great effect. However, with the current naval industry, Mr. C admits that only a madman would pursue this. Well, that's a good thing we're Polish. Because we're kind of nuts. There we go. A madman's plan. Actually, do you do that at all? Hey, thanks for annexing... oh, that's actually really good that they annexed Tanutuva early on. So this way we get them under us too. Which might have expanded their surrender limit, but that doesn't really matter to me at this moment. A, 36 carriers. We're going to go immediately for 1940 carriers. Yes, please. Level 3 carriers, as long as they're decked out, can do extraordinary things. Go, 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 go. I mean, we're doing so great here. So great. Stop extending the line against the Allies, please. You don't need to fight them yet. Someday, but not today. So much land in the Soviet Union. So much land. They had so much potential over there. Now they're actually... ooh, they're actually pushing into Italy now. It might be wise for us to push in there. You know what? Screw it. You know what we're going to do? We're going to do this. You probably... you might actually be pretty equal in terms of divisions. I'm sending you down here. We're going to go to war with these guys before the Italians capitulate. Obviously, Italy will be divided up between us and the Allies, but Germany's going to be completely ours. Just go ahead. Just move in. The Mexican states join them. That's fine. Cool. Get some more. Actually, how close are we to deciphering the Soviet stuff? About 4 months off. Less than 4 months. Less than 4 months. That's not bad. You keep beating them up. Even though that severely weakens our line around here, I'm not too worried about the Soviet line with them having less than 60 divisions in total, so... they gotta capitulate soon enough. 94% of the way there. If someone could invade Vladivostok, that'd be great. Of course, the capital is now Vladivostok, but whatever. Slowly coming in. Slowly, 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 which is totally fine. Hey, but the divisions over here are arriving, which is great. Give them some time to... get some organization, some planning bonuses. Some of these guys take quite a while to get over there, but whatever. Beautiful. So many factories, but of course, never enough. Any partisan stuff? Actually, we could probably do that. Where's some resistance? In the center here? Why not? We got more resistance probably down here. Especially near Stalingrad. Yeah, let's do that. And is anyone doing... yeah, let's keep one person there for now. Root out resistance. I like that a lot. 3. 2. Before we go to war, let's see if we have any more planes. Not really, but yes. Any more casts? Not really, but that's whatever. Yeah, I remember people have asked me before, why don't I ever train my planes? It's because I forget about them, first of all. And secondly, they get enough experience as long as they're in the field eventually, so I really don't care. I could micromanage stuff, but I really don't want to micromanage stuff. I really don't like micromanaging stuff, so... Ah, there we go. Yes. Yes, that's exactly what we wanted to see. They did not join the Allies, which is good. At this point, go ahead and push them in. Because I'm taking all of Yugoslavia. Doesn't matter. We're going to take all of it. Oh, maybe you didn't... Oh, I gave air superiority to the wrong group. My bad. Carrier development, a bonus. Oh, that's a little late to use that. That's okay. Well, let's do it anyways. Because we still have 1944 stuff to do. Despite the advice of our admiralty, we've chosen to pursue a naval plan based on the use of carriers. Our shipowners have no experience developing and constructing these vessels, so we should look to outsource some of the designs from foreign experts. It'll be a long process to develop the modern carrier templates. Yeah, that's okay. We got that. Quit India. Cool. And you guys are actually doing pretty darn well. Just going to force the attack. We got to get at least this part of Italy before we're done. So, I want at least Veneto. And maybe Lombardy. A nice little Italian puppet. At the very least, of course. Hey, that's circling. Nice. Good job, guys. Now they join the Axis. Now they're fighting down here, but I'm going to take all this anyways. And we're still winning on the front, which is good, obviously. 96% towards capitulation. Very good. We're all the way in Kazakhstan now. Don't want to be there, but, you know, we are. Hey, Bulgaria's there. Anti-partisan stuff. Do even more anti-partisan stuff. Improve medium batteries. Very bueno. At this point, we can begin making some of those ships. Actually, it's 42. Let's grab some more field hospitals, just in case. Goodbye. Goodbye. Hello. Medium batteries. Nah, those look cool and all, but... Light cruiser batteries are where it's at. Anti-air 3. I might even get better fire control, maybe. We'll see what happens. Level 3. We're gonna need some more... Naval XP, actually. Oh, I don't like that. Yeah, we're definitely gonna need more. God dang it. Gonna do that. That's all we can do for now. I'm not gonna do anything else like that. You guys switch. Train. Train. There you go. Yeah. Train, 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 train. Hmm. Weird that we're training in the middle of a war, but I think the Soviets don't really have that much more they can offer us. Or do against us, really. Hopefully we can kill off the Italians. That's still a lot of Italian boys down there. Still a lot. South Tyrol, and then Lombardy we'll want, so. Good. Still mobilizing more. Love it. Keep building yourselves up as well. Never enough. And actually, do we have enough radar decryption? Not really. Don't do it there, because we will probably release Germany to do that one. There you go. Cool. So, support equipment stuff. More engineers? Why not? Maybe better river crossings, more entrenchment. Even though we don't really need that much entrenchment right now anyways, but that's okay. Yep, these are foreign claims. Maybe not in Montenegro, but that's okay. Still not looking too bad over here. Stockpile, we are way out of guns. Everything else is looking pretty good. Eh, maybe super anti-air. There you go. That'd be fine. You can lower this by 5, maybe. I'm not gonna lower that, so... Share the wealth. Actually, go down here. We might actually use mechanized too, maybe. Mission encrypted stuff. Great. If you go down there, you can cut them all off. Nope. How about some more war support? We probably had some pilots killed. Yeah, war heroes being killed. Oh, those guys are screwed now. Against Yugoslavia. We don't like the Yugoslavians for some reason. Okay, there goes Yugoslavia then. Bye-bye! Cancel loan lease. Fall of Rome. Significant development. Are we going to have a double capitulation in this episode? Let's hope so. Hey. Dockyards. Not bad. For now, just keep making more subs. That'd be fine. You guys, let's throw on... I really like extra anti-air, just because enemy planes just come barreling down at us all the time when we use these guys, especially with our carriers, so the more anti-air, the better, I believe. Alright. Oh, they're so close! 99! 99! Italy is probably not going to capitulate first. It's probably going to be the Soviet Union. Holy cow, that's a lot of death. Or a lot of allied stuff. So we're done with this for now. Naval XP. Oh, actually, we could use that naval XP right now. It isn't enough to just have the biggest ships. They must also have the biggest guns. The bigger the gun, the bigger the happiness. The research and development of naval armaments is nearly as important as that of new ship models and engines. Absolutely. At this point, since Japan is dead, and we've been doing really well, we could go to war with the Allies, maybe. If we go to war with the Allies in this campaign, then in the next campaign, I probably won't when we come back to this mod sometime. Just, it is what it is. Ooh, cryptology, go and do these guys. And then, do that with those guys. Do the Canadians and Americans too. Because we can. Look at that, not enough manpower. Oh, we still need to go to war with these guys too. Ooh, actually... Ooh, they'll probably join the Allies if we go to war with them, so. Better anti-air? Why not? Man doctrine, air stuff. We're not even doing carrier stuff really yet. Naval bombers. Because why make carriers if you have no naval bombers, right? And there you go. Lagging really hard. Soviet Union, thank you for playing. No one's going to get any of this territory except for me. Not even the Finns, because they don't really deserve it. Thank you. BEA-utiful. Now, do we get this unlocked yet? Polish imperialism. Oh, actually, we gotta do the colonialist path down there, so that's okay. You guys have done a great job. Tremendous. So, everyone, how about you find yourselves on the Lithuanian border, and this might be a slightly overkill with this many divisions, but that's okay. Who is the weakest general here? 6665664. Hello. I'm sorry about your position, but you have too many divisions for now. Thank you. And go right there. There we go. Not bad. We mean no harm, but actually, let's do the imperialism one, because we might be able to get the puppet for these guys. I don't want to hold all this territory all the time. And there goes the Axis. Alright, I'm just going to take all the German Reich stuff because I said we would, because the Allies don't deserve jack squat. Let's see, I'm taking all of Yugoslavia because the Allies don't deserve jack squat. Well, in the peace deal, in the future peace deal, we might make this a little bit more balanced. Greece! The Greeks. Good job, Greece. Albania. Well, actually, I'm going to take this part too, and that part too. Cool. Romania, I'm just taking all of it. Alright, so the French can have this part. Actually, I want that part too. 4. That's gonna look really ugly, I swear to God. This is really bad. You know what? The Greeks can have this part too. I don't really care about it. And the Italians? Or, go to there. And go to there. And you guys can have this too. And I've not forgotten about Ethiopia yet. I probably will, though, if I didn't remember. Ooh, they have more land? Oh yeah, that's the part I wanted. Screw you, Allies. Pieces of garbage. Alright, now I feel confident enough to do this. You guys can actually go to another army, there you go. And you guys can actually come up here. Oh, led by someone else as well, still. There you go. Not bad. Cancel. Why would you cancel the non-aggression pact? Who's in the Allies, actually? Belgium as well? Okay. That's a case. Cool. You guys, you have done a tremendous job. Norway joined the Allies, okay. Well, good luck with that. Defend the line right there if you can. You guys will be fine. The tanks and stuff like you guys. Oh yeah, you guys are in the Allies as well. We're surrounded by the Allies quite a bit. Holy crap, that's not good. Well, actually, we'll get we have to divide things up a little bit better than this, then. You know what? I'm going to actually send you guys down here, because this line is not going to be very strong. If that's the case, you guys got to do this, too. So, 24 guys. Go right there. Should be enough for that. 20. Go right there. Defend against them right there. And I don't want to do this, but I'm going to have to. There you go. 20 divisions go right there, like that. take the weaker group and go right here like that. So we're still left with you, because you have to come up here like so. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to have you guys invade then. And then have you guys help them out. Shouldn't be too difficult, right? Because you guys are coming to come right here. Hopefully no one's going to justify on us. Like that. Cool. Oh, we can expand the steel network. Hey, there we go. Better carriers? Don't mind if we do. Which we'll start making pretty much immediately if we can. Which means we gotta make some... Actually, what is this? Let's see, the one on the right is a carrier close air support versus the one on the left, which is carrier naval bombers. Let's see, slightly less range, same air attack, same air superiority, same naval targeting. Let's see, reliability is the same. You have a little bit more over here. You actually cost less. You use the same amount of fuel. Reliability is the same. Ground attack? Oh, these guys don't have ground attack. Naval attack is 7. Their naval attack is 20. These guys are a little bit more agile. Slightly more defense. Barely slightly more defense, but that's okay. We'll keep using naval bombers then. We'll use those guys. Let's go and grab you guys then. Just in case. Ooh, naval ships. There you go. Even more anti-air. Tons of anti-air. Good hospital threes. Good, good, good. Recon on the recon. I love the recon. Better planes. Nice. Oh, we can go over with Countess. Good. This stuff, naval mission efficiency, naval doctrine. Let's start doing base strike, maybe. Actually, 43. I forgot about this completely. That's not good. 42. The change in non-aggression pact. Close air support 3. Oh, yeah. I love that. We've been doing this without any air support. Or very little air support, I should really say. Boom, 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 boom. And boom, boom. We'll just throw 2 on. There you go. And then one more. Right. There. Any more planes? Hopefully. Oh my goodness, we capitulate these guys, so there's actually quite a few planes here. Oh, what a bunch of trash. There we go. There we go. Nice. Can't duplicate this one yet. Engineer 3's, cool. Do that as well. There you go. And military police, we might as well, right? Cool, let's go and come down here first and do Colonial Empire. I think we've already read this, so... Let us remedy these mistakes and show the world that we can oppress others just as well as any other European nation. Love it. Now, it's probably going to cause World War 3, but whatever. Before we do forget about that, I kind of wanted to actually anti-sub warfare stuff. You know, I'll see what on. It's only level 1, but just in case, we might need it. We really actually might just need it. So take off one of those and start building up quite a few cruisers here. Because as much as we love subs, cruisers are pretty good too. And we can do this as well, so grab a little bit of armor. Just a little tiny bit. A speck of armor. Hangar space, radar, anti-air. Not bad. Dual purpose, we don't have enough for that. God dang it. So close. You guys are already down here. Both of you guys, get ready to rumble. Rumble in the jungle. Come down here, actually. I could give these stuff away, but I don't really care. No one's really our puppet. Oh my goodness. Look at all this trash. Doesn't matter. I just don't want to have to deal with this later on. I'll deal with these 22, because they can be pretty useful. Cool. There we go, more close air support, great. Fighters, nice. There you go. 1, 2, put them on. Oh, you have some on there. Throw some more on just because we could always use that. And then you guys go right there too. 3, 2. With enough air superiority, we should be doing pretty okay. Allies, why did you guarantee them? That's not cool. If that's the case, you know what? Give me a few more days, because we're going to build this area up quite a bit. And someone is barging into my room, and that someone is my cat, Binky. Bink, what are you doing in my room? Bink? Hey, Bink? What, do you want my chair or something? My apologies, everyone. Come on. And you took my chair. All right. So we have the war goal until when? I guess we're kind of forced to go to the war with the Allies then. That kind of sucks. But not really. We wanted to do a colonial empire anyways, so we must have justified these guys then. I mean, the World War II lasts until 42, and the Soviets are also dead, so... go figure. Yeah, I mean... alright. We're gonna need more air doctrine then, probably. Air superiority, definitely. By the way, these guys are gonna go around and try to kill us off. That's not cool. Alright, almost done with this. Just a little bit more naval XP. I need at least one more hangar. Just a smidgen more. That's okay. Over here, cavalry, light tanks. Air superiority is always pretty good to do. Screens, attack and defense. I like that screen defense, actually. 50% more defense is not bad. Over here, chief of the navy, decisive. Ooh, yeah, ship attack. Naval reformers, okay. Convoy rating. I always do convoy rating. You know what? I always choose this one. How about we do more convoy rating? If we can convoy raid a little harder, that'd be kind of nice. Colonial Empire. And does this unlock things? Oh, it does. It auto-completes. What is this? Purchase Madagascar and Cameroon. It costs 400 political power. We do not have the political power when this national focus is completed. We will gain the following national spirit. Hold on. Hold on. Enterprises in Liberia. And Angola and Mozambique. Polish minority in Brazil. Ooh. Oh, man. We're going to probably lose our war goal against Lithuania if we do this. I kind of want to see what happens though if we do this. We can buy Palestine? Oh, they don't own Trinidad. Oh, that kind of sucks. Colonial troops. Non-core manpower. Decisions to add resources to colonial states. Colonial exploitation. Let's... oh, my goodness. Who's in the Allies? America's not in the Allies yet, right? So we could probably... as much as I would like to... we can probably just go around this. We probably need to actually do this stuff. Even though this looks really cool, so we can buy them. I want to do that stuff, but still... let's improve industrial efficiency. Our military industry has come a long way, and as a result, our production of tanks and aircraft has improved significantly. We still have a long way to go until we can truly compete with the great powers, but what we have accomplished thus far is admirable. Cool, so I just want to get a little bit more naval XP. Just a little bit more. Just a tiny bit more. Air stuff. Go and get more air stuff. We're going to need that immediately, probably. We only have 500-some factories, that's all. Not enough. So, can we puppet the Tsar and stuff and... get Russia back, please? Go and do this one too. That'd be good. Do we have decisions to get the Tsar? I don't know. Let me know in the comments below. Should I puppet the Tsar? Should I really puppet the Tsar? Because I'm totally okay with it. But we get so many resources if we don't, and so many factories, and we can keep the people down if we really want to. I don't know. We'll see what happens. I'll leave it up to you guys. But with that in mind, it's November 4th. We have less than 10 days to go to war with the Lithuanians before everyone else here is really pissed off at me. So... Just get up to... can we get up? Just come on. Come on. Yes, we got up to 5. Yes, there we go. You, oh, wow. That's a lot more ships. Oh, there you go. That's all I wanted was 5 more. Quite literally only 5 more. Because then we can do this. More hangar space. Beautiful. Oh, crap. We need 5 more. Ah, screw it. That's good enough for now. We'll come back to it. Goodbye. 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 Carrier Fighter 2s, oh yeah, definitely make some of those bad boys, and then get some naval bombers if we need those, go to war, and we'll call it an episode. Cool, hope you enjoyed today's episode, guys. If you did, consider leaving a like, subscribe if you're new, check out my Discord link in the description below, and I'll see you tomorrow, when I guess we're gonna go to war with the Allies and see what happens. Thanks for watching, have a great rest of your day.